After a bomb explosion caused by terrorists on the British headquarters at Jerusalem, one entire corner of the King David Hotel, a building of seven stories, was razed to the ground. The stone floors were cut clean.
In scenes eerily reminiscent of New York 55 years later, the Jerusalem bomb was the beginning of terrorism as a media event, designed to capture the world's attention.
The latest casualty list included 65 killed, 47 injured.
The perpetrators, Zionist Jews, members of Menachem Begin's Irgun terrorist network. Begin, who would one day become Prime Minister of Israel, described this tactic as turning Palestine into a glass house where the entire world was looking in.
We were a minority, but we were a minority with a clear ideology that we must have a Jewish state to rebuild the state which was existing many, many hundreds of years ago. In a fight for liberty, you have always those who are more, call them extreme, or more adamant, or call them staunch, and they want it immediately, not to wait for the Messiah.
Jerusalem at that time, it was a fortress. And I walk through the town and put in my mind every place and think about how can we attack this place. If we succeed, it's very important, the whole world will see that we can fight even the British.
Begin and Ellis decided on a daring plan. They would strike at the very heart of British rule, the King David Hotel itself. If they succeeded here, the whole world would take notice. The terrorist bomb was hidden in seven milk churns and delivered in a hijacked pickup truck. The bomb went off at 12:37 and was devastating. But of the 91 dead, only 28 were British. 17 Jews died alongside 41 Arabs. Of all these, 54 were innocent civilians, unconnected to the British authorities in any way.
We started with military operations to make sure that the road between Tel Aviv and Jerusalem will not be endangered by the big villages or towns that were along the road. Wherefore came all the attackers on the convoys.
A special Haganah brigade was formed to open the road to Jerusalem.
The system was to attack the village, to give warning to the civilians, to destroy the village. And by the elimination of the villages alone and adjacent to the road, we were sure that there would be no attacks.
Two Jewish extremist organizations, Irgun and Lehi, which had fought the British, were eager to prove themselves in the new war.
It was such a tragedy. Deir Yassin was a lovely village.
The events at Deir Yassin would haunt relations between Jews and Arabs for years to come. Deir Yassin had stayed out of the fighting. It was not on the Haganah's list of hostile villages.
I ran into a man who had left us for the terrorists. He told me that the Irgun and Lehi had got permission from our commander to attack the village of Dir Yassin. He was very proud.
Blared out, "Lay down your arms. Run for your lives." Then I heard our machine gun. I was kneeling down like this. When I looked up, I saw the village ablaze. Their attack lit up the whole village.
The commander ordered a house-to-house attack.
So I gave the order. Before entering a house, throw a couple of grenades inside.
They threw a grenade into one house. 28 were killed.
It was impossible to attack the enemy without hurting their families. It was difficult. It was painful, and I'm sorry we had to do it. But we had no choice.
After the battle, they took 14 prisoners. They lined them up by the quarry and mowed them down. They threw their bodies in the quarry. That's what happened.
New immigrants were often settled along Israel's frontiers. They lived in fear of frequent Arab raids. Ben-Gurion blamed Nasser for the raids. He ordered the Israeli army to retaliate by striking Arab countries harboring infiltrators.
Ben-Gurion
knew Arab villagers supported these terrorists. We had to show them that helping terrorists was dangerous to protect our settlements.
I was called to see Moshe Dayan. A mother had been killed, murdered on a settlement.
The murderers left tracks which led to a village across the border in Jordan.
My orders were to reach the village in Jordan. We had to blow up as many buildings as possible and cause as many Arab casualties as possible.
The tiny village of Kibya on the Israel-Jordan border is in ruins as dazed survivors relate how troops struck across the frontier at night. They accuse Israeli forces of leveling buildings with grenades, shellfire, and explosives, trapping entire families in the rubble. The attack prompts the United States, England, and France to deliver their sharpest rebuke to Israel since its founding and to demand stern action to punish the guilty troops.